We started out about 5 years ago designing it, and it was designed for total care comfort. Well, it actually milks a cow, you know, individually, and you can actually get individual information on every cow. The robotics run 24/7. They'll milk a cow now 2 hours, 10 hours from now, where we don't have to have actual manual labor to milk the cows in 5, 6, 7 hour shifts. That's an advantage to cow comfort too. They can come and go where people are not actually moving them manually and causing more stress. We're averaging about 2.9 to 3 visits a day over the whole herd. Fresher cows, cows that just calved more recently, are coming 5, 6 times a day. It has all the information that you would ever want. It has conductivity, activity, anything to do with milk production. It tells you when a cow's off in milk production and possibly flag this cow when she's getting sick. So you have the advantage of this technology to help you take care of problems with the animals quicker and faster, and maybe diagnose and treat animals before they really have a lot of problems. Well, as far as Clemson is concerned, we feel like we want to be on the latest technology there is available, and this is something we're hoping the students can actually get some knowledge to be trained in, because these robotic systems are coming very fast in the dairy industry. We hope to, and we think we will see milk production increase after we get this system up and running, probably in six months to a year. Plus, we should see more longevity in cows. We also see this as a plus to South Carolina dairymen too. I think a year from now we'll be able to tell a lot of difference in what we've seen improvements in or deficiencies in.